Hello, yes. This is RetroTK2, and today we're talking about namespaces in C#. If this is your first C# video, I'd strongly suggest watching the series from the start. The card is on your screen now. And if you haven't already, I'd advise downloading the channel files that accompany this video. Card is on your screen once again. So let's get started. What are namespaces? According to the Microsoft docs, namespaces are heavily used in C# programming in two ways. First, the .NET framework uses namespaces to organize its many classes. The using keyword can be used so that the complete name is not required. Second, declaring your own namespaces can help you control the scope of your classes and method names in larger programming projects. Use the namespace keyword to declare a namespace. Namespaces have the following properties. They organize large code projects. They are delimited by using the dot operator. Delimited means to determine the limits or bounds of something. Yes. The using directive obviates the requirement to specify the name of the namespace for every class. Obviate means to avoid or prevent, by the way. I'm sure you already knew that, yes, but I'll be honest, I sure didn't. The global namespace is the root namespace. Global semicolon semicolon system will always refer to the .NET framework namespace system. The docs briefly mentioned the using keyword, yes, but what is the using keyword? Well, according to the Microsoft docs, the using directive has three uses. To allow the use of types in a namespace so that you do not have to qualify the use of a type in that namespace. To allow you to access static members of a type without having to qualify the access with the type name. Although this is not available in .NET 3.5, yes, which is the version Unity currently uses. However, if you click the card on your screen now, you can find out how to get this functionality with C# 7 and 6 in Unity. To create an alias for a namespace or a type, this is called using alias directive. The using keyword is also used to create using statements, which help ensure that iDisposable objects, such as files and fonts, are handled correctly. This last part is out of the scope of what we're talking about in this topic, yes, but we'll talk about using the using directive like this in a later video. So be sure to subscribe for that. The scope of a using directive is limited to the file in which it appears. Create a using alias to make it easier to qualify an identifier to a namespace or type. The right side of a using alias directive must always be a fully qualified type, regardless of the using directives that come before it. Create a using directive to use the types in a namespace without having to specify the namespace. A using directive does not give you access to any namespace that are nested in the namespace you specify. Namespaces come in two categories, user-defined and system-defined. User-defined namespaces are namespaces defined in your code. Most C# applications begin with a section of using directives. This section lists the namespaces that the application will be using frequently, and saves the programmer from specifying a fully qualified name every time that a method that is contained within is used. If you're using a previously written namespace that contains nested namespaces, you might want to declare an alias to provide a shorthand way of referencing one in particular. The namespace keyword is used to declare a scope. The ability to create scopes within your project helps organize code and lets you create globally unique types. Namespaces and types have unique titles described by fully qualified names that indicate a logical hierarchy. For example, the statement A.B implies that A is the name of the namespace or type and B is nested inside it. The doc also briefly talked about a global namespace. According to the docs, the ability to access a member in the global namespace is useful when the member might be hidden by another entity of the same name. When the left identifier is global, the search for the right identifier starts at the global namespace. The actual example seen in the docs talks about a class called SystemAce. The docs say, obviously, creating your own namespace called System is not recommended, and it is unlikely you will encounter any code in which this has happened. However, in larger projects, it is very possible that namespace duplication may occur in one form or another. In these situations, the global namespace qualifier is your guarantee that you can specify the root namespace. Right, a bucket load of information there, yes, and in many ways it overcomplicates a fairly basic topic. Let's see these namespaces in action. open up Unity and create a basic C# script. As always, make sure you give your script a different name than any other class in your project. I'll also be using Unity Spice for all our logging areas. If you'd like to get it yourself, follow the card on your screen now or click the link in the description. To declare a namespace in C#, type out the namespace keyword and give your namespace a name. Finally, open and close your curly braces. And that's pretty much it, Ace. That's about as basic a namespace as you can get, though it doesn't really do anything. To make it useful, we've got to add in classes and other namespaces. Here I'm going to declare a very basic class and another namespace. So now we can create an instance of our newly created class. It's tricky doing this with ReSharper enabled this because it'll automatically import the relevant namespace while I'm declaring the basic class. If I remove the using my namespace directive, you'll see we get the error cannot resolve symbol basic class 22. This error, as ReSharper rightly corrected, occurs because we haven't identified the class we're trying to use. Our basic class belongs to the namespace my namespace, and so we need to type out my namespace.basicclass22. As you can see, our error disappears. However, importing the namespace is usually a much nicer practice. Using ReSharper, you can do this by pressing Alt and Enter to import the missing using directives automatically. The advantage of using the using directive over the my namespace dot method is that you don't have to keep typing out my namespace dot anytime you want to access basic class 22. One other important thing about using directives is you have to declare all of your using statements at the start of your file, and adding one after a class definition will give you the error unexpected token. Okay, so we've seen how to use a nice basic namespace, but what about nested namespaces, Ace? Here I'm going to declare another class called myClass22 inside the scope of our another namespace. Right, now we'll create an instance of our myClass22 class and see how we get on. Here we get a similar error, Ace. Since myClass22 is inside the two namespaces, we need to reference both of them in order to access our class. We can either type out myNamespace.anotherNamespace.myClass22, or we can import the namespace using our using directives. All fairly obvious by now, yes. Notice how we have two using referencing my namespace. If I was to remove the using my namespace, you'll see that our basic class 22 throws an error. Both the using directives are necessary, yes, and have different scopes, so please do bear that in mind. It's also worth noting that you don't have to include all your code inside the same declaration of your namespace. You can reference the namespace again by simply typing out the namespace keyword and the name of the namespace you would like your class to be under. This is great, Ace, since it allows you to split your namespace declarations over multiple files. Another pretty cool thing we can do is define our class inside the mynamespace.anothernamespace in one go. So instead of having to place our class definition inside two namespace definitions, we can remove the namespace another namespace and add mynamespace.anothernamespace instead. Much neater, much tighter, and much better, Ace. The Microsoft docs also mention the global namespace. So here I define a class called myClass22 with a nested class called System and a property called Console. Well, .NET already has a System.Console class defined, so if we attempt to use that System.Console class, we'll see we get the error cannot resolve symbol console. Our System class that we have declared is hiding the .NET one, Ace. So in order to access the .NET version, we have to put global semicolon semicolon in front of our System.Console.WriteLine method. I've got to be honest here, Ace, I've never had to use the global keyword, and I would almost go as far as to say that doing so is probably a very bad practice, especially if you look at the examples given in the docs. In both cases, the programmer is creating a class or namespace called System. There is already a namespace called System in the .NET framework, so creating anything called System should ideally be avoided. The global keyword does let you get out of this jam, I suppose, but would it not be easier to just call your namespace or class MySystem or something more relevant to your project? Using the global keyword seems to add more hassle, in my opinion, Ace, and if you work on a team, you're passing on that hassle to every member of your team with little to no payoff. Okay, rant over. You can also create your own namespace aliases, Ace. So say you had a namespace with a number of nested namespaces, you could set that equal to your alias instead, and just use that. jolly good. This has been a pretty good look at namespaces in C#. And that's it. Rate, comment, and subscribe, Ace. I trust you'll use namespaces in your code. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with your woes. Thank you for watching, Ace, and I'll see you in the next video.